Welcome back to our web development course. In this lecture, we're going to look at HTML tables. So I hope you're ready to learn with me how to implement HTML tables. If you are, then let's get started. Audio Jungle. Before we begin, I would like to communicate something to you. Have changed the way how I'll be approaching. Actually, I'll be preparing notes for every video that I make. Then I share the link where I can download those notes in the description of each video that I'll be making. I'll do my best for each video. At least I'll be creating notes, either slides or a PDF file where we can learn more and understand each and everything that we study. However, in the side of video, we shall be concentrating on what? On practicals. I mean, real coding. So I hope you're ready to take this with me. So for example, for today's notes, if you're interested in them, please find the link in the description and you'll learn more about tables. But here in the video, we're going to concentrate on tables. Tables coding, not just tables description and whatever, okay? So I hope you've get my point. So let's begin like this. If you need to download, if you need to learn more, you just download the link, you just download notes from the link, and if you need just to know the coding, then you concentrate on the video only. So let's begin. Now today we're going to look at tables, HTML tables. To create a HTML table, it must be having HTML tables always structured in two parts. One part is the head and one part is the body. So it has T head and T body. Anyway, let us first create a structure of HTML. To create a structure of HTML, just write HTML and press the tab key. People who are using Sublime Text, you can install packages and implement such a thing. Just write the name of the tag and then the press tab key, then it will do what? It will auto suggest all the tags. So I'm going to write here HTML tables. Okay. So I'll come back here down and write my table. Maybe I'll put H1, H2 and say my budget. I'm going to put my budget in this table. My daily budget in this table, okay? So, as we say that HTML tables are always divided into two. The upper part, which is the table body, the table head, and the lower part, which is the table body. So the tag that we use, first of all, HTML table must be surrounded by a tag called table. For example, write the word table like this. I'll open the tag and write the word table, and then close the tag, and then close it like this, okay? So that's the basic table. I mean, everything that you need to put in the table to be between these tags. So you divide now the table into two. One into the head and the other one into the body. One as the head and or the other one as the body. So to write the table head tag is just write T head, okay? Then press the tab key, it will be like this. It will open and close. So, and the other one below this T head, we shall have a what? T body, like this, okay? So there are two now. Here's where we shall put the content, and here we shall put the headings. I hope you get the point. Now the heading always have their only one row, and in the body we normally have multiple rows. Now for example, we come here to the heading, and we're going to put there our values. So we need a row. We first create a row, and within that row we put what? We put cells. Okay? So to create a row, we just write TR. It represents table row, TR. Then press the tab key, that will be auto suggested and completed. So in this TR we now put cells, okay? Now remember this is the heading, now put cells. These cells, they are called table head, TH. TH then it is the table cell in the heading. So TH, if you do like this, table head, for example, you put here ID or serial number, SN. It means that since it is in the first and it is in the head, it means this is one complete column. Then I'll come after here and create another column. it should be like th and then the tab key, and I'll put maybe the item. Okay, item. Okay, then I'll come down here and open the tag again, th, and put maybe what item. I put price, I mean unit price, unit price. Okay, I'll just write price, price. Okay, then I'll come back here and put another tag, th, which is maybe quantity, qty, and then lastly total, HT is equal to total HD, TH, sorry, TH is equal to total, it's been small letters, TH, sorry for delay, it's got total, okay, like this, okay. So you're having now three columns. I repeat, we begin the table and divide the table into two, one as the table head and the other one as the table body. In this table head, we put a row, okay. In that row, we just define it as TR and then we close that TR. Then we start writing cells in this row. So these cells are the first one and are always in the head. It means that we have created how many columns? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay? Those are the columns and we're going to feed information. So we come to the table body to start feeding information. Now, also the table body, to feed a particular information, you must first create a row. Maybe you want to enter one record, then you must first create a row for that record. We use still TR to create that row. Okay, then I press enter. And now I have to fill information according to this. Now, here I must be having serial number. This is in this row, I should put serial number for this one product. So I'll put maybe TH and then press the tab key, maybe 001. Okay. So I've filled this column, okay? So what's remaining is this next one. So I'll do like this and put TH and maybe put what? Soap, okay? Then I'll come back here, I write again TH and put the quantity, of course. You see, they should be matching price, maybe 120. And I'll come down and put TH again. And what is next is the quantity. Remember, this is the top heading, the top header. So this is the quantity, and I'll put maybe 3 bars, whatever. And then the last one is the total. So you have to do what? To put T data still. Okay. Sorry, this is supposed to be TD, not T head. Maybe that's the total. That times 3 is equal to 260, huh? Or 160, okay. Then this one should be TH, if you want them to be TH, and here TD, sorry, TD, and here TD, table data, because it's not the heading, so I have to be table data. Otherwise, if you make them like this, yes, they'll come out, but while they are bolded. All of them while they're bolded. For example, let's leave only this to be bolded since it's the serial number. So this is a record for only one value. I run the program and you see, I say open the browser. I'll just switch. Okay, I refresh. And you see, I've entered my budget and I have serial number. It is kind of bolded. And then the item, and then the price, then the quantity, then the total. Now let us add more. To add more, of course, you must first create a what? You must first create a table row, which is TR, like this. Then you shall write TD, which is the table data. Again, maybe I can first paste this one as how many? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, and the last one 5. Okay, maybe I'll put this one is 0, 1, whatever, okay, an ID 0, 0, 2, 3, okay, or 2, whatever. Then I'll put maybe what here, I'll put the name of the item here, okay, name of the item. Maybe I'll put sugar, okay. Then I'll put the amount, maybe 90, 85, whatever. Okay, and then I'll put the quantity, maybe 6, maybe 3 kilos, maybe 4, I'll hit 3. And then lastly, I'll put the total, maybe whatever it is. I won't multiply it, okay? So if I come and refresh, you can see the second row has come. What makes that be possible is this TR, the one that makes it possible. And what makes the IDs to be, for example, it should just be H, okay? What makes the IDs to be kind of bolded is because of this TH, okay? So let us add one more record and shall write TR, okay? I'll write TD, table data, and press the tab key and copy. To press and duplicate is Ctrl Shift D to do like this to duplicate. Or you can still copy it and paste, okay? So I'll put 003 and I'll put here maybe sold, maybe 50, 59, okay, 50. And then the amount maybe 1 and then the total of course 50. So that's the information about the table. So if I switch to the table, I refresh, you can see another record has come. So let me make a summary of what I've discussed before I go. First of all, we have changed the policy. If you need to get more notes about tables, find the notes in the description and there is a link, you just click on it, then you can go and download those notes. And then you have said that a table, it is surrounded by the table tag, and you said that table tag, it is divided basically into two, the table head and the table body. In the table head itself, you shall put the what? The table heading. And you do that by first creating a row, which is TR, and then start putting TH, which is table header, by just filling it up to the number of the forms that you want, the number of columns that you want. Then after, you come to the body, which is taking the data, and you do this using maybe the body is used to take the data, and we do this by first creating a table row, and that table row should match with the previous one in the heading. Then you start defining table data up to the time that you feel like all the fields in this one are filled. So this, to create another row, still you create just TR and do like that. When you just say TR, it will be portioned, and a table will be creating another row. Then that inside that TR should put the table headers and table data to do what? To be stored in the table. Otherwise, if you don't do like this, then the table won't be in the right structure. So I hope you've got introduced to tables of HTML, and don't miss in the next one. We are going to learn how to modify these tables of HTML. It's going to be interesting, and I hope I'll see you there. Please consider subscribing to our YouTube channel, because when you do so, we get more energy to make other wonderful videos. And thank you for watching up to this point. See you.